God to make their religion seem overly important so people don't ask the real questions about what it all means. I've said it before and I will say it again. Open your ears. And if you want an open your ear t-shirt, then send me a text. Next message left on the line was from this guy.
Hey, I really like watching people die.
Thanks for calling. I tell you what, people say I'm nervous and paranoid, but I'm not. I'm not, dear listeners, because I'm not nervous, I'm fearful, and I'm not paranoid because this stuff is true. There is a whole secret world that is kept hidden from us that makes everything make sense, and I understand it, more or less. And it's my mission to help you understand it, too. You see, my buddy, my friend, my mentor in my new life. We'll just call him Philip Trevors. Yes, his name's Philip. Well, my friend Philip, he's such a guy, man. I really want to get him on my next show, but man, he doesn't want to. He even left this message.
Rod, you there? You better not put me on your show, you fucking prick, or I'll drink the blood from your...
guy. Anyway, he thinks it's not true. Thinks I'm paranoid. But he's wrong. And that's the thing. Smart people, the most brilliant people, like Philip Trevor, whatever, they don't get it. They don't get it, and that's the point. Big science and big pharma, that's how the whole house of cards works. They've tricked the clever people into actually believing their nonsense. It's the genius of the thing. Get the clever people and the stupid people will follow. Right? 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 Wrong. I'm leading a stupid person fight back. One idiot at a time. Here's a message left for the show.
Hi, Ron. Your show's great. I listen when I'm out metal detecting. In case you don't know, metal detecting's hunting for metallic objects. You know, using a detector. I find all kinds of stuff. Mostly made of metal. Once I found an expensive engagement ring and I fantasized about the woman that wore it. What it'd be like to be with her, caress her, stick a knife in her throat, you know, just like a real wife. You can find a lot of clues in a metal detector. Like the one about bees being gay. Anyway, what do you think, Ron? Love the show. I'll hang up now.
Here's what I think. The bees have disappeared because they know that the shit is about to go down. You know how a horse gets nervous before you take a semen sample? So you have to talk real nice to it, rub its chin, and then grab his number and crank the life out of it. Maybe I'm getting ahead of myself. That's the show Beyond Insemination, which is also on this channel. But what isn't on this channel until now, listeners, is the startling fact that in the ancient text of the Sumerians, they talk about the Anunnaki. Lizard beings that descend from the sky. This is in Mesopotamia, which is modern-day Iraq. All those wars over there start to make sense now, huh? It's not about oil. It's about lizard people. Hiding among us. Here's what I know. You're a searcher. You seek truth. We won't be tricked. I'm leading rebellion with the stupid people. A goddamn rebellion, man. A real one, because we're the last hope. For mankind, I mean. The smart people, the geniuses, they've already been taken. Zappos got them. Big science has got them. Big pharma, big soy, big corn. These soy corn holding assholes. Which takes us to our next listener who called in. Really interesting stuff.
Ron, I'm tired of soy. Definitely tired of soy sauce. I'm tired of soy latte drinking bitches. I went to a restaurant and some geisha had the audacity to hand me a hot towel. She thinks I should take a bath in front of everyone in the restaurant. It ain't decent, it's a fucking insult. And then she tried to give me some shit called edamame. Those are damn soybeans, you ain't fooling me. 10 of them little fuckers and they want to charge you $5. What do you think, Ron? That soy bullshit gave me man boobs. I've got my hands on them right now. I'm hanging up now. I'm getting all excited again.
Interesting. Big soy, big corn, or big con. They pulled this lie with contrails. They did it with contrails.
Somebody explain to me why we have the largest military budget.
God help me, man, she's freaking going crazy. With those itty-bitty grinds, don't get you down to date, but now scare the mother.
Listen, women were not meant to make artistic montages around their lady parts, no matter how pretty or imaginative. All kinds of sparkling things in your thighs and above your lady lips is now, from here on out, banned. It ain't proper. That stuff is for men only. I cannot feel like I'm about to tongue a disco ball. Life is not a hip-hop video. Get rid of the Beaver bling. Is that clear, girl?
Yes, Dwayne.
Louder.
Yes, Dwayne.
Now say it like you're enjoying yourself. I'm just kidding, messenger. Now, dear listeners, I have a confession. I am sure this revelation will do. That baffles medical science and kills most people that contract it. But I look at it as a ray of sunshine. I have a great disease. Alcoholism. I have won the lottery. I mean, yes, I could have gotten herpes, but I didn't. Should I? This disease is great. Sure, I end up sleeping with some ugly chicks, but now that I know the symptoms, I know how to take care of myself. For instance, it is unwise to mix cocaine and grain alcohol for more than 3 days at a time. And that's a fact I have learned. Some fella told me that at one of them meetings, and he gave me a hug and a keychain. Strange business. I do not hug men, no thank you. I hug girls and procreating sows, and the latter only to ease the process as nature intended. I spoon men, just like any other normal fella, but hugging? Hugging with your arms around another man? Are you serious? Whatever will they think of next? Who's on the phone and how can we go beyond insemination?
My name ain't important.
Oh, it's my old friend Clarence, everybody. You son of a gun. Clarence is a stand-up guy. I say that even though he is in a wheelchair. Clarence and I fought in the war together, right on the front lines of the war on terror. We drive around at night and join a cold war. We saw a foreigner acting squirrely. We called 911 right after we shot him.
Dwayne, I got good news. I don't need the wheelchair no more.
It is a miracle. My prayers have been answered. Many a time when I was down on both knees giving a working girl the business, my mind would turn to you and that you are a cripple that can't enjoy the pleasures of the flesh.
No, I don't need a wheelchair because I got a motorized scooter now. The Relax Power X for ambulance. Do what I had that thing lowered. Neon. Custom paint job. Overhaul the engine. You wouldn't believe the mad booty I've been getting lately. Besides, the doctor said I don't need a wheelchair or whatever and that I can walk just fine. I'm just tired, Dwayne. You know how I do. I like to sit down, have a beer, masturbate, you know, relax.
Oh, that's wonderful news there, Clarence. I love hearing you're getting moody. Thanks for calling into the show, buddy. I love you, always will. We received an electronic message in our inbox last week that says, Dwayne, you are so great on the radio. I was wondering if you've been watching the TV reports about how over in Asia they've got the epidemic of bird flu. Well, thanks to everybody for writing in, especially to the listeners asking for a signed photo of my blessed memory. Now on to your question. I do not give a crap if some bird has the flu. Do I pause if a robin sneezes or a parrot coughs? No, I do not. I'm not a veterinarian. The maladies of animals are irrelevant to me. People raised a stink about swine flu, saying it was gonna ruin the bacon. That barbecue tastes just fine to me. Let's move to the final portion of our show. Romantic interludes with Big Dwayne, where I call a previous love interest live on air. Today, I'll be calling Marnie Smith, the cheerleader I went to high school with, and harbored feelings for that I kept at bay by throwing Chinese stars at strangers and indiscriminately burning things. But today, I shall bless her, as I have obtained her phone number. I am so excited for this year.
Hello?
Marnie. Hello, Marnie. This is Dwayne Earl. And as you can tell by the melodic and poignant music playing in the background, I am about to unleash a barrage of emotion that has been trapped inside of me for these past 20 years. We attended Central High School together, and I sat behind you in science class. And on days when there was a football game, you wore your cheerleading. outfit. To this very day, I nearly break out in tears that I have not told you of the thunderous lust you arouse in me. Now, I would not break out in tears for real, as a man's tears are saved in a special place for when his favorite stock car driver loses. But know this, I, as often as this week, have kept you in regular rotation in the Dwayne Earl Spank Bank. I fantasize about you turning around in science class. Skills in archery, knife throwing, and camouflage face painting in particular.